Still considered to be a classified report, more than a 100-page section of the Henderson Brooks report has been made public. The report outlines a comprehensive operational review of India's military debacle in 1962 in the India-China War. The 100-page section of the first volume has the report has been published by Australian journalist Neville Maxwell on his website.
It holds Mr. Jawaharlal Nehru responsible, and rightly so. The humiliation, the defeat which India suffered in 1962 was a direct outcome of the way Jawaharlal Nehru, under the pressure of V.K. Krishnamenon, ignored the concerns of Indian armed forces, and they were left to fend for themselves in a state of complete unpreparedness. The nation still feels the pain of that humiliation. The BJP would like the entire report to be made public, so that more than 50 years thereafter, the nation must know as to who did what wrong. And surely, Jawaharlal Nehru has to account a lot for, and maybe the time has come that the future generations of India must debate who secured India more, Sardar Patel or Jawaharlal Nehru.
I have already said that those who breastbeat and indulge in jingoism are not true nationalists. The Congress has never played cheap politics with a much more dangerous contemporary war called the Kargil War, because we believe that true nationalists stand together on such issues. For the BJP to rake up a 1962 issue at this stage, which is the result of a complex multitude of diverse reasons, and I'm happy to have a historical debate on logistics and defense preparedness, but to try and mix it up with individuals or political parties shows that for them, everything, including the nation and defense preparedness, is grist to the political mill. And I think that is the true level of nationalism, as opposed to jingoism, which the BJP shows. The Congress has, in much more serious lapses in the 99 issue, been always given constructive inputs, and I don't agree with any of the various innuendos which are floating around on this.
I can give you any number of examples of what was the ground situation at that time. We did not have a road link between Srinagar and Leh until late 1961. We did not have a road connectivity to any of the posts. We had only one brigade there, while the army wanted two brigades. One battalion was sanctioned. No armament was supplied. Nothing was there. Yet Nehru asked the army to have forward policy. So the whole situation was so pathetic at that time. No preparation, and Nehru was constantly lying to the country. He told the country that there was no aggression, no occupation by the Chinese. Chinese were good people, they were our friends. He made the country believe in all these things. He was lying to the people.